One of the few car segments in India which has a semblance of perfect competition is the subcompact sedan segment, and the newest kid on the block is the Hyundai Aura. The subcompact sedan segment in India saw an overall decline of 28%, with Hyundai seeing a massive 54% decline. Hyundai hopes to change this situation with the new Aura.
The Aura is to the extent what the Grand I10 Neos is to the Grand I10. This is basically the new generation model of the Accent. Of course, it's called Aura, and it takes inspiration, design cues, and even components from the Grand I10 Neos. And that is evident in the front end. It is very, very similar to the Grand I10 Neos, right down to the hexagonal grille and the twin set of boomerang-shaped LEDs flanked on the inside. The projector headlamps are the same unit as well. Apart from that, the car gets a few creases on the bonnet and the profile, adding more character to the look of the car.
The rear two sees significant changes, with the boot lid now getting a sculpted look, and the Z-shaped wraparound tail lamps with the 3D outer lens add to the overall design of the car. But we aren't exactly fans of how the weight looks. The chrome element on the boot is a bit of an overkill, and the tail lamps too don't quite sit well with the overall design of the car. The Hyundai Aura is 3,995 meters long, stands 1,680 millimeters wide, and is 1,520 millimeters tall. It has a wheelbase of 2,450 millimeters, and boot space stands at 402 liters. The dimensions make it a decently spacious car, and it can comfortably seat 4 people, with the rear seat being particularly comfortable. The interior of the Aura is exactly the same as that of the Grand I10 Neos, albeit with a different color scheme. Our turbo-packed test car had the same crash pad on the passenger side, which ups the premium feel, along with the 8-inch touchscreen infotainment system, which comes with smartphone connectivity as well. The dual-tone grey interior with splashes of red adds a sense of sportiness inside. Hyundai has done well to offer a bucket load of features on the Aura. These include two USB charging ports, wireless charging for mobile phones, and a rear view monitor. It is the same as the reversing camera, except it can be switched on even when the car is moving forward. The Aura also gets a bunch of standard safety features, which include dual airbags, high strength steel body, rear parking sensors, and anti-lock brakes with electronic brake force distribution, and seatbelt pretensioners as well. Hyundai is offering a 1.2-litre petrol and diesel engines, along with a 5-speed manual transmission and an AMT gearbox option. The 1.2-litre petrol makes 82 brake horsepower and 140 Nm of peak torque. The 1.2-litre diesel makes 74 brake horsepower and 190 Nm of peak torque. The new addition is a 1-litre turbo GDI petrol engine, which is a segment first. All engine options are BS6 compliant. For commercial fleet sales, Hyundai will continue with the Accent Prime and keep the Aura nameplate for private customer sales.
We are driving the 1-litre turbo petrol variant of the Aura, and it is the same engine as the one found in the Venue. Now this motor, it is a rev-happy engine, and once you go past the 3000 RPM mark, that's when the engine comes to life. And it's a comfortable highway cruiser as well, so you can comfortably cruise on triple digit speeds all day long. There is an anemic reaction when you're below 2500 RPM, but once you go past that, you'll like what the car has to offer.
The Aura offers a plush ride quality, with the suspension nicely balanced. It is slightly firm, resulting in sharper handling over its predecessor, and not losing its calm over regular sized bumps and potholes. The response from the steering is sharper too, and you could feel it especially when filtering through city traffic. Needless to say, the Hyundai Aura does impress us with what it has to offer in terms of performance and features. The car is a definite upgrade over the Accent in terms of looks as well. Maybe. prices start at 5,80,000 rupees and go up to 9,22,000 rupees, undercutting the Maruti Suzuki Desire and the Honda Amaze, two of its biggest rivals, by a slight margin. Is it value for money? Yes, definitely. Should it feature on your consideration list for a subcompact sedan? 100%. Hyundai says there is a significant chunk of customers who like to opt for the top spec model. The top SXO model of the Aura is about 36,000 rupees cheaper than that of the Maruti Suzuki Desire ZXI Plus. But will this really translate into an advantage? Knowing that the Desire is a bestseller, the Aura has its hands full.